Hello and welcome to another random battle replay cast. And guess who's back again? Eagle185, who's playing a different ship that we usually see on any featured channels or any YouTube channels. This is the Z46. But first of all, again, thanks to Eagle for sending in so many formidable replays that I can't feature. It's unbelievable. And this one has also a funny incident in it, but we come back to that later. Let me just summarize what is good about the Z46. Well, the German ships in general are not so considered, or are not considered to be like super powerful or whatever. More rather weak, kinda. And for most of the German destroyer line, that's totally applying, in my opinion. At least, especially tier 6, tier 7, tier 8 are really questionable, in my opinion. Not really fun ships to play. Yeah, you can make them work, but they are not crazy good. From tier 9 and the tier, or the tier 9 and the tier 10, in this case the tier 9, they are becoming really good. And their like features are slow, quick torpedo reload with pretty stealthy torpedoes. Good AP on the guns, quite decent reload. Of course, they are got no gunboats, and they have a formidable hydro. In case of the Z46, that is basically 5 kilometers. On the Z52, you have almost 6 kilometers, and that is easy. If there is no razor present around the cap, you can bully out every other destroyer. No way that he will do anything towards you. And that makes them so strong. They are pretty, pretty strong cap contesters. They enable your team to spot the enemy shoot the enemy DDs because they are spotted through the hydro. On top, the Z46 has also a pretty good concealment of 5.9. Or let's say it's not the best anymore, but it's among it's a pretty competitive concealment. Let's say it like this. Definitely workable. HE, as on all German ships, is pretty pitiful, I would say. AP, and that's the good thing about this AP, has a high alpha. Not the best penetration, but a high alpha. And yeah, this AP of the German destroyers enables, or also hits hard on destroyer broadsides. So whenever you catch a destroyer broadside, just switch to AP and you make a massive damage. That's how they are played usually. Of course, if they angle, you switch to HE and will have a struggle. Z46 has also on top its main armament, or the main armament in the back. I'm sorry that there are notifications, but I had a video sent into Jingles and he he basically advertised my Twitch channel. That's why I'm getting some of these follows. So thanks to the guys that are doing this if they're here around. But yeah, where did I stop? It has its main armament, two turrets in the back and one in the front. On the Z52 it is two in the front, one in the back. So I prefer usually the more aggressive, which would be two in the front, one in the back, but you can kite enemy destroyers in the Z46, therefore. It's not such a good ship, like, offensive-wise, if you charge in and so on, because you don't have your main armament in the front, as I said it. One of the biggest weaknesses I find is the short duration smoke. That's how they Wargaming decided, okay, that's kind of a balancing factor, and yeah, that's okay, and so on. But you see Eagle using his AP here. It was a nice 2k chunk on that Hindenburg. So whenever you see ships broadside, you can smoke up and fire AP at them if it's good to do so. I'm saying like this. Alright, so he secured the C-cap. We are playing on North. It's just a tricky ship, tricky map. Especially if you look at their lineup. They have a Wooster, they have a Donsker, they have a Salem, that's triple radar. They have a Chungmu, could also equip radar. A Cossack can be annoying because it's outspotting him. Shimakaze is outspotting him. But apart from that, it looks quite okay, I would say. But of course, this game is I'm not featuring it if it wouldn't be like a bit special, so so there's definitely more to come. So he's making his way towards the B cap. They lost already two destroyers, which is always a bad sign. Without destroyers, and this Kagero is about to die as well. He's sneaking on a Hindenburg, who most likely has Hydro. And yeah, let's say the chances of him torping the Hindenburg are very slim. And the only thing that happens is probably that he gets killed. So that would mean that Eagle is the only destroyer left on his team. And therefore, he wisely chose to go as quickly as possible for all the caps, because you need to build up some points over the battle. You can't have the enemy getting all the caps if that's possible. So avoid that at best. Yeah, Kagero pushed out widespread torps to Hindenburg and is getting killed by Hindenburg torpedoes. Congratulations, Mr. Kagero. That was not really great. But as an experienced player, you see when something is about to go wrong, and that was pretty foreseeable for me at least. And also Eagle said return back, because he also knew what is going to happen, and exactly what did happen, exactly that. Alright, so I said you need to get caps, because the enemy is already, since they have a majority of DDs alive, in this case all four, have an easier time capping the caps. So to not fall behind too long and give your team time to actually kill other ships than destroyers, you need to get caps for sure. This torpedo salvo was quite nice on the Richelieu on flood. Oh yeah, one weakness of the torpedoes, they have also very a low flooding chance, but that's mitigatable by the quick torp reload. And you see him using this AP here on the prod side, always recommended. You could also use HE. It has a low HE alpha, but it has a pretty good fire chance. So that's kind of, that's how Wargaming balanced these ships kind of. And you should be aware of it if you're playing these, in my opinion. So it's also viable to use your HE. The fire chance isn't bad. Alright, so he tries to go over to A and help to spot the enemy destroyer. That's probably the Shimakaze, because he was last spotted there. And is probably smoking something up, or himself, I don't know. Yeah, that close to a Salem, that's questionable. Did the Salem react? Will he react? Yeah, he reacts. So these torpedoes are not really hitting anything. And then this is basically the what the fuck moment. Hello? A Wooster? 4 kilometers away, I'm so dead. That's exactly how every destroyer player that knows what a Wooster is capable of is thinking at that moment. Luckily, he's having some torps there. And yeah, he thinks, okay, if I'm dead anyways, well then I can at least take out the Shima to give my team a chance to to win. The Wooster is eating one torpedo, which is good. Oh, another notification. And he finished off the Shima, switching to AP. At least I would do that immediately. Because full broadside, as I said, he also sets a fire, which will also stick. Two more top hits on the Roma, so it's gonna be a mess. And yeah, you see how quickly this Wooster melts. Okay, he ran into like a lot of battleships and so on. So I don't know why he didn't even radar for his team. I don't know why he didn't use Hydro. That was a very questionable play by the Wooster. Usually you think that's you're dead in this situation. I mean, if I would be Eagle, I would have been 100% dead. I'm pretty sure about that. I'm pretty sure. So yeah, that comes, or every now and then you have just such luck. He also reduced the DD population of the enemy team by one, so that's always helpful. We all know how a single DD can stop a whole flank of pushing just by fearing the battleships, like as if he could, could devastate all battleships if they are pushing one line or so. That's not going to happen. Yes, over time he can whittle them down, but that takes time actually. Alright, so that's A secured. That was really important because this gives his team some breathing room. And as I said, you need to play on time. Right now they have actually the lead, so in terms of ships. So the rest of his team wasn't lazy and did nothing. No, they actually killed some ships, which is good. Oof. That's heavy AP from a Sanem, I assume. You saw how much damage that Bismarck ate on his broadside. Ouchie, ouchie. Alright, so Hachung Mu looked as if he would approach towards B. Also, the Cossack was spotted up there. So this is two destroyers in one place. This is really good. And yeah, here we can see a demonstration of this AP on destroyers. Four hits. 4k damage. Eight hits. I think there were also 5k or so. That Chung Mu doesn't know what's going to happen to him. He's wondering, what the heck? How am I losing a health that much? So that's what you really should capitalize on in your German destroyers. Also, Cossack is spotted. And now he's using the smoke, but he actually did smoke up in the radar range of the Donskoy, which is of course also not so great, but I think he had no other choice. The Cossack can be a fucking annoying gunboat and is pretty strong for its tier, and that makes life definitely not easier for Eagle. But I wonder why he shot AP here. That was very interesting. I didn't know that. It would make sense. And now he is probably wondering, hey, am I spotted? And he is not even returning the fire, but he can't because he doesn't see Eagle. And somehow he survives also the radar, which is hilarious. And please have a look at the chat. Nice cheat fucker. Says the guy in the Cossack, who has also access to Hydro. Hmm. Alright. That's very interesting. How is he able to cheat? I wonder. I really wonder. I have no clue. How is it cheating? Hmm. Oh, he reports him. Okay. Well, he's a filthy cheater, isn't he? So, of course I'm reporting. I don't know the game mechanics, but I'm reporting. Of course. And another notification. I'm sorry guys, I'm using OBS here and not my Streamlabs, but somehow the notifications are still up. I don't know why. And he's thanking his teammate who gives him already a plus one, so this is at least equalized. And is saying that he's trying his hardest. He's doing a really well job, really good job, yeah. It's called Hydro Pro, he says to the Cossack. Report Eagle a cheater. Okay. Yeah, it's a... very interesting, yeah, just very interesting. So he's reversing to try to get shots on the Salem here, on the broadside. Don't lie, lol. So where did he lie? Well, I think the Z-46 has Hydro, right? A pretty formidable German Hydro. But obviously he's lying, because he doesn't... he doesn't say that he's a cheater, right? So, obviously he's wrong. I sent this Robling replay to Wargaming. Okay. Ah. Well, the answer of Eagle is pretty cool, actually. He seems to be a really chilled guy. I would just, like, put in so many emojis and would, like, make so much fun of that guy. You're a fucking cheater scum. Please do so. Yeah, I would probably answer something like this, because Eagle knows if he would send it in, the whole Wargaming abusive cheating department would have a good laugh at that guy, for sure. So, how's that guy named, by the way? Vogelhund. Oh, he's obviously a German. Who would have guessed? And now we see a demonstration here again of the AP on the Salem prod set. You see 2 to 3k salvos, easily doable. Sometimes even more. And obviously he's using the islands to go behind and cover. And since Wargaming changed the spotting mechanics here, like one or two patches ago, where you can just go behind an island, stay silent for 2 seconds, and you are unspotted, which is a really, really good comfort thing to have. Donskoy radaring again, but this time it's not that problematic since there is no destroyer, it's only the Donskoy and the Tirpitz. Tirpitz is not really accurate, and Donskoy doesn't have the best reload, and he obviously doesn't have the radar module with which increases his radar duration, so that's obviously also helpful. And that allows Eagle now to play more aggressive, to close the distance, to smoke up, and to use his AP on the Donskoy broadside. So you saw your team lose, so you used your cheat code? What? I didn't even saw that until now. Holy moly. Interesting interpretation here by the enemy Cossack, by Vogelhund. Ahem. Yeah. But yeah, if you don't know it, it must be cheating, right? Also, is a good explanation why the player base is as fun or as bad orientated as it is. You saw your team lose, so you used your chat mods like a loser. Losers can't lose like you. Okay. Okay. Losers can't lose like you. Don't know what to say towards this. That means I have right. At this point, even Eagle is a bit pissed off. And yeah, the Tirpitz, probably very unexperienced player, crowned himself there. There was actually nothing that he would have to fear, except for the friendly Tirpitz in North Carolina, but yeah, we see that very often, that people are not aware of their surroundings and ram themselves into island. This was actually not a not so tactical beaching, no, no, that was just, yeah, not having the awareness. And Eagle is just farming him. Maybe he gets his Kraken, which would be absolutely deserved. As a cheater, obviously. Mad, very mad Eagle. Yes. He's having the game of his life, and he's probably very, very mad. Ah, I love it. And he kills the Tirpitz finally and gets his Kraken in. Really great game there, and also very entertaining thanks to the enemy Cossack, who, yeah, was a lot of fun to read his chat. Yeah, 250,000 damage. I think I never achieved that much in a Z46. Confederate, high caliber, Kraken, all the good stuff you want to have. Only Wither would be missing, but he didn't fire that much HE or didn't have so many floodings going on, so that would have taken a while to gather it. In total, 9 torp hits, but 388 shell hits. And I don't have the detailed overview screen, sadly, but you saw how much AP he shot. So a big chunk of this damage here is, I would assume, around 80 to 100k is definitely the damage from the guns. So a very well played game, apart from getting accused of being a cheater. And a very well played game, where he played for the team, where he played for the win, results often enough in a really good base XP value. So as he did here. So he was up tiered. Well, he was in the middle of the bunch, let's say it like this. I mean, not so many tier 10s. And yeah, there were some radar, but radar cruisers didn't play too well, in my opinion. Especially not the Wooster. But yeah, so 3.381 base XP. That's also quite outstanding. And yeah, just reflects what I always say. If Eagle is sending me a replay in, I'm most likely gonna feature it, because it's always interesting. It shows good gameplay. This time also has an amusing part, so absolutely crazy good stuff. Yeah, so thanks again, Eagle, for sending this in. Keep this good stuff up. I'm really appreciating every replay you send in. To you all other guys that probably watched this video, well, if you liked it, give it a like. And if you like my content I produce, well, feel free to subscribe. Apart from that, I wish you as usual a nice day and see you next time. Bye-bye.